Yes, I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I want, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father.
Shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell, though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, this only do I seek, that I dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord. Says of you, seek his face. Your face, Lord, I will seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away. Forsake me. God, my Savior, though my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of my oppressors. Do not turn me over to the desires of foes, for false witnesses rise up against me, spouting malicious accusations. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong. Take heart and wait. Wait for the Lord. And all God's people said amen. Amen. Say amen again. Amen. Because we know God is good, say amen again. We have come at this hour to share with this family as we remember and reflect upon the life of Mr. Jimmie Lee Henton. We're thanking and praising God for this day because in spite of everything else, we can still say that the Lord is good. In spite of everything else that we're going through and dealing with, we can yet say that the Lord is good. The family has provided a program, and we shall use this as a means to carry out this service. We do ask that at the needed time, at the time of come, that you will come and do that which the family has requested of you at that time. We ask now that you would join us in prayer. Eternal God, our Father, we come to you now with our heads bowed, asking you, O God, to look down upon this family, asking you, O God, to give them strength in this hour, realizing and knowing, O God, that there is nobody but you who can take care of them in this moment. Nobody but you, O God, who understands just what they are going through. And, oh God, it is my prayer that as you look down upon them in this hour, that you would even now bind the hurt that they might feel. It is my prayer now, God, that you would comfort them and allow them to know that even in this hour that you are still God, that you're still able, and that you can do anything but fail. And, oh Lord, as we are praying to you, we thank you for this life. We thank you, oh God, for this father and this grandfather and all the things that he has meant to this family. We pray, oh God, that in their sorrow that they would know that you are the lifter of the bowed down head. So, God, lift up heads now and allow them to look to you for their strength and their comfort. We ask these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our scripture comes from the book of Jeremiah, Jeremiah chapter 31, one verse, verse number 13. And it says, "Then shall the virgin rejoice in the dance, both young men and old together, for I will turn their mourning into joy and will comfort them and make them rejoice from their sorrow." Amen. At this time now, we will have a musical selection. We're going to ask Brother Vass if he would come at this time and do this musical selection. Amen.
Good afternoon. I know in a time like this we feel dying and out, but how many know we may do it for a night, but y'all gonna come in the morning. But I believe that God have a smile on you. How many know he'll set you free? Even like this, then God smiled down on you.
The program provides an opportunity for those that would like to come and share reflections, that you may come at this time. Family and friends who desire to would like to come and share, you may come at this time to share reflections.
Good morning. How everybody doing?
All right.
I tell y'all now, that my cousin Jimmie Lee, God was a spoke. And every time he come around, he used to love to talk about the old time. And we'll sit there, we'll talk about it, And I try to think of something I said, talk about it. Yes and all, now, cuz, that ain't the way it was. You got it wrong. I said, no, cuz, that was sin, so, you know, back in then. No, cuz, that ain't the way it was, cuz. You got, but Jim, he gonna get you right. And every time he saw me, he gonna make time and spend time with us, and we sit around and have a good time. But girl, I just wanna say, you know, we all gonna miss you, and we do know the law don't make no mistake. So rest in peace, my brother. Rest in peace.
I just can never picture myself being up here and speaking about my office. You know what I'm saying? We should have expected it, but we didn't expect it. But to me, Walker was in a weird sense of way, he was a sense of leadership. You know what I'm saying? Before he had been leaving after our Archie died. Had been taking us in the right direction, and a lot of times he stepped up a lot of time. You know what I'm saying? I know I stayed over his house many times. And he, you know, it's just something that I'm going to miss. It's just generally not being there for me. Touch, you know, knowledge, leadership, whatever he had to give me. It was in a weird sense of way, but he kind of like led me and guided me. But it's just something not going to be replaced by Jimmie Lee Henton.
God who knows it all. There's a God who knows it all. He rules the land, all power in his hand. There's a God who knows it all. Sometimes my burden get heavy. Sometimes it's more than I can bear. So I just fall down on my knees and talk to Jesus. 'Cause I know he'll answer a prayer. There's a God who knows it all. There's a God who knows it all. He rules the land. time, my friend misuse me. Sometimes they scandalize my name, yeah. I just fall down on my knees and talk to Jesus, 'cause I know he'll answer my prayer. There's a God who knows it all. There's a God who knows it all. He rules the land, all power in his hand. There's a God
it all. Amen. And there is a God who knows it all. There's a God who sees us and he understands just what we're going through. Again, we give honor to God for our being here today, and we're thanking and praising God for the blessings that he has showered down upon us. In spite of everything else, we know that God is still good. We thank God for this family, and even as you're sitting, you friends who have come to share with this family in this hour, to share briefly with you from the Word of God, from a very familiar passage of Scripture found in Psalm 23. Verse number 4, it says, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me." And just briefly, we want to share with you from the thought, strength to go through. Strength to go through. As a family and as friends who have gathered here, this familiar passage of Scripture is a Scripture that is read time and time again. As children, we are taught Psalm 23. You know, if we ever been anywhere near the church, that's a passage of Scripture that we've learned, and we've been able to recite it time and time again. But as we learn it as children, and we continue to hear it, the meaning of it changes as we grow. When we first hear it and we first introduced to it, we learn it as a means of wanting to make sure that we know a Bible verse, if you will. And then as time goes on and when we move out of children to become adults and we start experiencing life, then we have a new understanding or a new appreciation that the Lord is our shepherd. But then this particular verse here, verse number 4, says, "Yea, though I walk through." And when you begin to think about how life comes at you from so many different ways and so many different things happens to us from one day to another, sometimes we don't know where we get the strength to even make it. There are some days we are perplexed with the problems of life. We seem as though when we are getting to a point that everything is going well, then all of a sudden we're hit with something else. And before long, while we're dealing with one thing and moving on to something else, here comes something else that comes at us, and we're still trying to figure out, how am I?
those of us who found ourselves with our backs against the wall, if you will, for those of us who found that we had to walk some time with our head down when we couldn't hold our head up because life had beat us up so bad, strength to go through, and you don't know how you got the strength to go through. But can I tell you, yea, though you walk through the valley. And see, when you think about walking through a valley, there is never a valley that feels good. There's never a low point in your life that feels good. There's never a time when you're up and all of a sudden you fall down that you want to stay down. But going through the valley, you've got to know who's walking with you. Going through the valley, you got to understand that friends get tired and they don't want to be in the valley with you. But when you're going through the valley, yea, though I walk through the valley, you have to understand that in the midst of the valley, that's when God is able to deal with you. That's when God is able to get your full attention, because you find out that a whole lot of folk that were hanging with you don't want to hang with you when you're in the valley. But then you come to understand something. It's in the valley that God is able to reason with you. It's in the valley that God is able to tell you that you will make it through this. It's in this moment of grief where you're sitting there right now. There's somebody wondering, how did we make it from last Friday to today? Because last Friday, you thought you didn't have the strength to make it when you learned of your father, your grandfather, your uncle's death. But look at the same God that took care of him in life is the same God that walked with you throughout this time. Yea, though I walk through the valley. And my final point with you this afternoon is simply this. Walking through the valley. Notice we didn't say you got stuck in the valley. You've gone through the valley. And when you're going through, when you get that strength to go through, it means that you're not stuck. It means that somebody somewhere is helping you to get from one point to another. Can I tell you who he is? His name is Jesus. He's walking with you. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. And it becomes a satisfaction for those of us who tried them. Anybody here tried them, you can know that there are going to be moments in your life where you feel that you won't make it. You're going to be moments when you feel you can't make it. But yea, though I walk through the valley, I can still lift my hands. Yea, though I walk through the valley, I can still say that God is good to me. Yea, though I'm walking through the valley, I can tell somebody I'm never alone. Yea, though I'm walking through the valley, I know that the same God that took care of me yesterday is going to take care of me today. Yea, though I walk through. And then can I tell you, never start going through the valley thinking that you're going to have a whole lot of folk with you. Because see, it's in the valley that folk are able to now look down on you. And when you're down in that valley, you feel that there's no hope for you. But can I tell you who's there with you? Can I tell you, because the word reminds us that, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. I will not fear those things that try to take my mind. I will not fear those things that's telling me that God has left me by myself. I will not fear those things that tell me that I'm the only one that's going through. I will not fear those things that make me believe that because I've done wrong in my life, this is why I'm going through this. Because yea, though I'm going through the valley, God is walking with me through the valley. He's keeping me. Anybody been in the valley and you felt that you were by yourself and then God say, hey, I'm here with you. I'm covering you. I'm keeping you. I'm keeping your heart. I'm keeping your mind. Stay on him. So family, if I can't tell you anything else today, I want to encourage you simply by telling you this. Walk through the valley. Go through the valley. And know that as you're going through this valley, that you're not by yourself. Because the same God that took care of Jimmie Lee is the same God that'll take care of you. How do we know that? Because in the midst of sickness, he took care of him. In the midst of pain, he took care of him. And even when it seems as though there was no hope at all, God was still right there taking care of him. And if he took care of him, he'll take care of you. So as you go through this moment, recognize, realize, and understand that God will be with you as you're going through. And he will give you the strength to make it through. Trust him, believe him. And know that no matter how it looks today, there's a brighter day coming if you trust in him. Pray with me now. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you. We thank you, God, for blessings. We thank you, God, for this family. And we pray that as you will continue to look down upon them, that you will strengthen them in this hour. Help them now, God, to know that even in sorrow, they can lift their heads and rejoice. Even in the midst of sadness, that there is a brighter day coming. For God, we realize and we know that just as you have come now, you're coming back again. But you're coming back with us, giving us the assured hope of knowing that there is a place that you have prepared just for us. So God, in this moment, we thank you. We praise you, and we ask that you will continue to look down upon this family. We thank you for traveling mercies for those who have traveled from afar. And we pray now, God, that you will continue to keep them. We ask all these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Program provided that we will have a musical selection coming from Sister Janie Porter. She is guiding here, so we're going to ask that she will come at this time to do her solo at this time.
Thank you. will be with you. He has not said life's pattern is one we'll understand, but he's promised he would keep us in the hollow of his hand. He has not promised days serene and free from all alarms, but he said that underneath us are his everlasting arms. God has not promised mountain heights as on through life we go, but he said that he'll be with us in the valleys dark and low. The family of Mr. Jimmie Lee Henton is most appreciative for all the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that have been shown to them during this time of sorrow. They ask for your continued prayers in the days to come. May each of you continue in the blessings of the Lord. The following floor arrangements have been sent to the family. With deepest sympathy, class of 1996. With deepest sympathy, Dre and Gloria Fields, South Carolina. The family spray that adorns the casket is given in loving memory of a caring father, grandfather, brother, uncle, cousin, and friend. Love the family. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, and the J.W. Williams Funeral Home staff would like to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. For scripture tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. The J.W. Williams Funeral Home family presents to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our hope that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you shared together as a family. And finally, the J.W. Williams Funeral Home family presents to this family a memorial keepsake blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket has to hold. It is our prayer that you are blessed now and always.
Let's prepare now for our committal service. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of this our deceased brother, Brother Jimmie Lee Henton, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working, whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, again, we thank you now. We thank you for all things, O God, realizing, knowing that even in these moments of sorrow that we can lift up our heads and we can look to you. Thank you, God, for your peace, and thank you, God, for giving us the strength to go through. We ask now that you will look upon this family and that you would give them comfort in these hours, knowing that without you, nothing is possible. Because of you, all things are possible. We thank you and we praise you. We ask these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.